Greetings, sir and sirettes, and welcome back to Ark Survival Evolved with me, Lathrix, and welcome to my new raptor, Bertha, as named by Twitter. Well, the original suggestion was Big Bertha, but Bertha became the version I preferred for this little raptor fellow. Well, that was a little bit silly of these guys, wasn't it? Well, they hit me once, I killed them. Lovely. Today, we are going on a bit of a hunting trip because two new animals have been added to the dossier. The... what do you call them? The Mega Dragonflies. I don't know what their full name is. Apparently, I accidentally killed one while I was doing building earlier, so they must be tiny. But I'm on the lookout for one of these. I've not seen one yet. Apparently, they're docile, but can become incredibly aggressive if hit, and then there's multiple of them, and it can be kind of scary. Also, there is a new water-dwelling animal, the Trilobite, or the Trollobite. It's one of those names, again, people have different versions. It's either the Trilobite or the Trilobite. I say Trilobite, I'm not sure if that's correct. Anyway, small armoured creatures. Oh, please don't say that's a dragonfly being attacked by a Dilo. It is! It's one of the dragonflies! Kill the Dilo, there we go. Ow! What are you attacking me for? Ow! No, I want to have a look at you! I can't look at you for freaking attacking me! Okay, I'm gonna stop here. Look, they're the dragonflies. Die! By the way, sadly, they are not tameable, which is... okay, let me have a look at your corpses. Don't. Eat the... no, 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 no. That's because you're on follow. That's because you're not on follow. There we go. That's it. Defend me from the other one. Let me have a look at you guys. Aw, they're kind of cute. The settings are a little bit higher today, so there might be a little bit of frame loss, but... oh, look at the water in these settings. Everything's so much prettier in these. Oh, look, another raptor. So, yeah, these are the new animals. Apparently, they serve the same purpose as the ants, being just less aggressive. I also have heard tell that they actually take up the same spawn thing, the same spawn markers. Drive-by pooping there. Which mean that the ants will be less common with these guys around. Also, the ants fight these guys, and these guys fight the ants. So, it's kind of a self-cleaning mechanism. Now, the Trilobites, I've been told by a few people, can actually be quite difficult to find. They're apparently in shallow waters, but are more likely in the ocean. You know, in the shallows of the ocean, as opposed to in the shallows of just rivers and such. For two reasons, apparently. One, I think that's actually how it's meant to be. And two, the bloody piranhas kill the trilobites. So, yeah, and there's lots of piranhas. Bit of lag there, of course, loading everything in. So, there's one more thing I want to show you all before we continue. Ooh, got a saber over there. What level are you, Mr. Saber? If you're over level 50, I might consider grabbing you, actually. Where's my doodah? There's my doodah. As you can see, I've been building recently. I've got all the engrams on my thing. Is that it there? Is that the parasaur that's running away? Well, saying that, if the level 20-odd parasaur survived this long, it probably isn't too high a level saber. But you never know, though. You never know. It could be extremely high level. Excuse me, where's the saber gone? Well, saber's vanished. That's a shame. Oh, well, it's too slow to the draw. Yeah, there's a new item. Ooh, are those... there's either some... there's a raptor there chasing a Fiomia. Oh, look, here's the ants. Let's get rid of the ants, away from the ants. Bye-bye. Well, that parasaur's just running away from the air at this stage. So, yeah, new item. Items, engrams. It's... quite far... no, it's not too far down, it's like halfway. It's quite a good one, this is. There you go, a sickle. A curved tool, ideal for harvesting fibre from plants. Now, sadly, I can't make this for quite some time until I level up. Oh, go away, buggers. But I will be making that as soon as I can, purely because that's the big thing that's currently slowing down my building. As you can see, I've basically walled up this entire section now, which is awesome. I also found out something. They've now changed how doors work, so that if you're mounted and you use the action button, which would normally dismount you, and you're close enough to the door, it does actually open or close the door, but I think it's only on the larger animals. Now, now I jumped off twice. I know it works with the mammoths. I know it works with my Rex. I haven't tried it with a raptor yet. Let's see if it works. There you go, yeah, so it does work, just then you have to be exceedingly close and actually looking at the thing. So I guess you'd have to be like... wow, the hitbox when you're on such a small animal is tiny. And that's its foundation. Okay, so you can't... okay, yes, you can close it. Excellent. Anyway, Yes, we're going to be hunting the trilobite. We're also going to be looking for some supply drops, because I've been told by a friend that apparently you can get the sickle, or at least its pattern, its, what do you call it, the engram, the blueprint, from some of the lower tier supply drops. Now, I don't know if that's true or not, but I will be on the lookout for those. Also, we're going to be on the raptor today, because I've had enough of being on the overpowered mega creatures I currently have. And this is quite nice, because it means I'm actually actively trying to avoid some of the other creatures. Now, is there anything in the water here? No, like I say, we should really get to the oceans. I mean, well, that's why I'm going this way, because this does lead to the ocean. The Spino's stuck. Oh, I love it when they walk. They're so cute. I love those so much. They are easily one of my favourite additions since I started playing. Oh, the piranhas and the ants, probably my least. Okay, back in a second when something interesting happens, or I just get to the ocean and our hunt can begin there. Well, I found something interesting. Here's a floating corpse. And here's the poor raptor, which killed the floating corpse. Oh, that's so sad. Look at that. It's like, please come down. Oh, you poor little critter. I'll leave you alone. I don't want to aggro the raptor. Hopefully when we get back, it will have disappeared, or perhaps even fell. How did it even get stuck? Like, it's not even stuck on something. I don't know what it's stuck. Is it on that tree? I think it's on that tree. The problem is, if I get off the raptor will aggro. Also, my helmet broke because I accidentally aggroed one of those tiny little things, which I was saying were one of my favourite animals, the little birds. Well, that was a epic fight. Anyway, back in a second when we get to the ocean. So what I'm going to do, anyway, okay, actually, yeah, let's speak about a bit of a battle plan, a bit of a stammering as well. We're going to get to the ocean, we're going to have a look around for a little bit, and if we can't find one of the trilobites, we're going to go to our base and give Derp a little bit of a visit, and then we're going to have a look in the ocean more thoroughly. So, let's get there. Okay, so we have reached the shallows. Let's have a quick look, see if we can see anything out of the ordinary then. So apparently they're found on the extreme shallows and around rocks around the ocean. Of course, like most new animals, the one of the big problems is if things haven't loaded in yet, then... Oop, hello. Oh, you're both stuck on a rock. That's so... Okay, let me just free these two little dolphins. You stay there. Stay there. There we go. Hello, little guys. Oh, please say this is breakable. Oh, I'm so sorry, this must be a new item. I was going to say, I haven't actually seen that colour of rock before. Oh, I'm so sorry, guys, you're both stuck forever. Oh, I'll come back and maybe put you out of your misery if you're still stuck later. Because it'll either be me or a shark, to be honest. I can't see anything just yet, which means they may be a little bit lower than I'm currently looking. Because I'm looking, obviously, in the extreme shallows right now. Focus and check it. More rocks. Yep, lots of rocks. There's definitely rocks around. These guys are just masters of getting stuck in places, aren't they? I literally just threw away all my prime meat as well, because I was getting overburdened. Hey, y'all. There you go. You got some food. Enjoy your meal. Timing those is a bit slow unless you've got some prime. Ooh, the cyber tried to kill a group of turtles. Obviously didn't end up too well. There's Predator Island over there. Still nothing. I may have gone past one and not seen it, but it's quite difficult to see with the glare on the... Ooh! Ah, it's a fish! Damn it! All my hopes and dreams. Well, we're getting close towards the old base anyway, so... Okay, I think we're going to have to go actually underwater for this. Back in a second again, most likely. Well, I've just had a look on the wiki, and turns out the wiki's finally been updated to actually give some information on these things. Oh, hello, little friends. And wait, how did you manage to aggro the turtles? Well, I'm going to end up killing everything if I do this, but let's see if we can try and save the dolphins. But yeah, it turns out they've finally been updated, and the trilobite, or trilobite, however you want to pronounce it, is actually meant to be found in the rivers more, in shallow water, and occasionally on beaches, is now the official thing. But seriously, how did these things even manage to aggro these? Because The only animal these things attack automatically is fish. Must have accidentally smacked one while trying to eat a bit of fish. Anyway, yes, yeah, so there's a good chance we won't actually find one looking where we are currently. But if we go towards the base, there is a river very close by, which is extremely shallow water. So we may as well continue down the path we're already going, since, well, we're already almost there, so there's no point in not doing that. Yay for the wiki being updated. I guess that's one of the problems. The wiki tends to be slowly updated because pretty much everything you put in there, unlike actual Wikipedia, needs to be reviewed and such, or at least the official one does, the official release of the wiki does. So obviously, until someone can prove what they've said, well, they're going to have a hard time putting it on there. Oh my lord, here they are. Stay. Now these things, again, aren't timable. Oh, they've done such a good job on these! I just pooped! In excitement! Oh, wow! These look way better than I expected. Sadly, not timable, and apparently, they give you a lot of chitin, which I'd imagine, so they're made of it. Die! Do I attack back? No, okay. There we go, killed one. Yes, really sadly, it's really sad they're not timable. What kind of loot do you give me then? Meat, chitin, yeah, that's to be expected. Pearls! Oil! That I didn't know. You give pearls and oil? How do you... What? You give oil and pearls. Oh my lord, that's going to make it so much easier for people getting into the game. Not, maybe oil's rare. Okay, let me just kill them with the raptor. No, just... Let's finish him off what I'm doing already. Sorry, I'm guessing the axe is the best one. I don't know, is it axe or is it... No, the pickaxe is definitely the better of the two. At least from what I've just seen. I don't know, how do you harvest oil from an animal? I don't really know how this works. There's definitely more than what I've just killed. I'm sorry, but I do actually need the pearls, so... Well, that's interesting, isn't it? So if you're not in the mood to go deep water diving, because that is probably one of the most... Actually, no, I don't mind it. Honestly, they've done quite a good job with the water-based segments in this game, so that's not too much of an issue, really. So the question... Also, I hope the banging isn't getting onto the microphone, but it's currently being... there's currently some work being done next door, which, of course, is leading to the whole apartment kind of shaking a little bit when the hammer hits the nail, so to speak. So they are definitely found in the beaches then, that's okay. To be fair though, that was the first group I found so far, and it's been a good 15 minutes. But still, oil! How much oil do I get? I mean, I just grabbed 17 oil, 6 pearls. I mean, obviously that's not too much, so obviously getting pearls is still better to go underwater. But it just means that early game, you can get some of the... I just saw something, apparently. Oh, it's a little coal. Aha! My raptor killed a coal. Yeah, early game, when you first get the stuff like the fabricator and everything, the trilobites / trilobites will be probably the best source of that. Oh, wow, level 90 Dilo. Should have timed that, but already aggroed it, so... So at least I've got some experience for little Bertha here. I'm trying to level up Bertha's damage enough so it can take out some of the larger animals, but I think it's going to take some time. It's probably going to take at least another 10 levels before it's actually... Whoa, there are more rocks than I remembered. Well, that is reasonable. Hey, Derp's okay. Is Derp... Yay, Derp's still... I love how they still haven't fixed that. I hope they never do. I hope they never do. Hello, Derp. Got some treats for you. Yo. Because your meat's probably all gone rotten. Droppable items, yes, and I'll give you half of the meat. There we go. Hello, Cookie. Oh my love, they're so ridiculously friendly. Hello, hello guys. Would you like some treats? There you go, here's some meat for you, and some meat for you. There you go, you're happy now. And I'll give you some meat as well. We've all had a bit of meat. Just give you, oh my lord, look how much meat you had on you. There you go. Get the rest of that. Onwards then. I'm going to look in the rivers and see if we can find some more of them actually in the... Because if they're in the rivers, then they're definitely going to be really good early game. I mean, admittedly, you always start off in the ocean, but... Ooh. This whole area is counted as shallow. I wonder if they're spawning in here. I mean, that'd be good. Give me more reason to actually visit here again. because at the moment, really, this hunting cabin is going a little bit unloved. Also, some of these wooden panels flipped. Can you see that? It's because they used to always go on one way, but now it's changed, and they've swapped since the change. This is a shame as well. There's so much going on here with the farm, which I still need to redo. Actually, no, I'm doing the more complex farm soon. This as well. I mean, there's just not enough stuff here for me to destroy. That's the problem. Because all I'll get is just like the base materials. That'd be so difficult to ferry back and forth. Got some crystals. Oh yeah, the shotgun. I forgot about the shotgun. I'll take the gunpowder. I'll take the hide. I'll take the fiber. Honestly, the rest I'm going to keep because I've got better guns now. There's no need for this. It's too heavy as well. I'd take it if it's a bit lighter. We've got metal doors, water jars, door frames, crop pots, way too much hide. I've got 10 sets now. The old water skin. Ooh, I'll take the skin. A ready ladder, nothing special there. How about in the cook pot? We have two bad recipes. Ooh, actually one good recipe, actually. That one I do want. The healing potion, I do want that. And anything in this hidden mortar and pestle? Which I've used like once. Nope. Anything upstairs? Nope. It's kind of a shame when you outgrow a place. Oh, there, and here's my original hut with the compost heap. Sadly, no finished compost would have took that. Charcoal, a bit of wood. Single rare mushroom, I'll take that, because that's in some recipes. Okay, well, then let's go find a river and see if we can get the trilobites there. Again, a dolphin being attacked by... Obviously, I know they're not actually dolphins, but I will still call them that. Being attacked by a turtle. Oh, look! Trilobites! Ow! Damn it! Damn it! Ow! Okay. Stop! Turtle, go away. I wonder how good the raptor is at harvesting these things. Oh, yeah, they can be found deeper than I thought they could. Ooh! Well, there's oil and pearls. It's a bit hard to control this thing underwater, believe it or not. The raptors aren't really made for this. Also, they actually have less oxygen than me. Never mind, they have more oxygen than me. Must be levels. Hello. Oh, look, you're all banged up. You're being friendly now. I wonder if you attack the trilobites. It doesn't seem like it. Oh, look how good these things are at climbing. Why can't you tame these things? Apparently, and I quote from the survivor profile, they're too dumb to tame, which is kind of sad. There we are. Oh, look, that'd be so cool if you could tame them, though. I don't really know what you'd use them for, but I don't know. I mean, I'm still waiting for the new snails to be added, which will be able to actually literally make cementing paste, which that's going to be awesome. That's going to, again, there's so many things now. A lot of people have said that the game's too slow, but it's now become clear to me that that's because a lot of the dinosaurs and the animals and all that good stuff, which are involved in speeding up processes, simply haven't been added yet. Okay, well, they're definitely found in good numbers at the ocean. That's good enough. So let's see if we can find them then in the rivers. Okay, so here we are at the local river. Let's find out if they're being found here at all. You see, the problem is, how it's worded on the wiki is very, very cryptic at the moment. It's basically one sentence saying they're found in shallow water and occasionally on beaches. Which could literally just mean, now I'm thinking about it, that they're found in the shallow waters of the... Ooh, hello. The shallow waters of the ocean, but then they're also found occasionally on land, as we did see that earlier. So they might not even be found in rivers at all. Oh my lord, level 60. Oh, I haven't got any stuff. Oh, well, it's good that I couldn't control my mouse there. Very high level, but I haven't got anything to tame it with. I could try. I mean, there's meat nearby. Do I want to try and tame the level 75? Probably not, no. It's going to take too much time. I'll do that later. Also, like I say, with the piranhas, because I have been told, though, by several people now, it's been confirmed by a couple of people, because I asked them after in one of the cuts, rather. Can you find them in the rivers? And they said yes. It's just extremely rare. So it might not even be intentional that they're found there. It could be an unintentional thing. Or, like I said earlier, it could be that piranhas kill them, because apparently piranhas do aggro on them, according to several sources. So, just going to stop to eat this dodo. I've almost leveled, so I'm just trying to get a little bit of harvesting done to actually level up. Hello, piranha. I love piranhas in shallow water, because they can't fight back. Ooh. Go away, you bug. I hate those bees! Bee slash ant things, there we go. 598% damage. I'm not sure what the base damage is for raptors, but it attacks so fast it really doesn't matter too much as long as it's half decent. Getting a lot of random FPS spikes. I'm getting a smoother overall FPS recently since a lot of patches, but a lot more spikes of just FPS going insane. Hello, Parasaur. What level are you, Mr. Pinky? Level 15. Anything here? No, it doesn't seem like it. So, from what I've seen so far, if they are found in rivers, they're found much, much less often than the ocean, so you're still going to want to go by the shallows. Whoa, the textures aren't loading in yet. There you go. Ah, early access games. So many little eccentricities. Let's call it that. Wow, even the raptor's graphics just some despawn for a second there. That was bizarre. I must be trying to load in something. Oh look, that's where we killed the broodmother. I guess the gun will still be there loaded up. Okay, there's a large river over here. We can follow that river, but the problem is it's not shallow. I could try and kill the spino. I mean, I could very easily outrun it if things start to go bad. And of course, if I win, I'll get a load of experience for the raptor. Oh look, two of the dragonflies. Hello. I like the dragonfly. See, that's how I feel the ants should have been. Aggressive on... Wow. Dragonflies just killed the giant scorpion. That is terrifying. And that Dilo's going to meet the same fate. But you see, that's what they should have been, in my opinion. Strong enough to fight back and everything. And, you know, aggressive if they get hit, certainly. But just not as insane. That was insanely aggressive. Oh god, the spikes at the moment. I think it is just one of the latest patches as because I have heard again that a few people are suffering from this. See, it does help to know at least 10 people who play the game and like talk to them regularly, because you can find out if things are just you or is it a common occurrence. Oh, I'm gonna jump off because I saw the poison. I was like, well, that's either an ant stinging me or a scorpion, and either way I don't really want the poison. Got such high torpor stats. Oh, ants! You know, we were on a mission. See, this is the kind of place I'd imagine they'd spawn in. So by the looks of it, I'm going to go out on a limb here and say this, that if they do spawn in rivers, if they even do, you know, on purpose, because it could have just been an accidental thing, or it could literally have been them just moving up the shallows, then it's exceedingly, exceedingly rare in comparison to the beaches. So if you want them for oil or pearls or whatever, go for the beaches. Now, I do know that I can definitely kill carnos. There we are. Mega Raptor. Then there's these slow ant drones just walking up. At least the drones don't sting. They're really making it easy to get chitin these days. A lot of recipes actually are chitin or keratin. I think for the first time, keratin's probably the harder to get. Even with the Rex killing things like one shot. Okay, I think I'm going to give up my hunt now. I think we've looked for long enough in the rivers and not found any to either say that they don't spawn, or it was an accidental thing when they were first released, or they're found more on the beaches. And yes, I think I've definitely read the wiki wrong, so I do apologise for that. Anyone who's watched this for more than 5 minutes at least will hear me say that, at least after I said it. So I'm going to say, yeah, definitely on the beaches. So, thank you so much for watching, Sir and Sirettes. That was my hunt for the day. There'll be more ARK coming out soon. I know that some of you were saying that ARK suddenly vanished from my channel, but again, that was from the move, and I'm finally getting back into the rhythm of making videos. The next video will most likely be base building and planning, or if something else is released, cool, we'll be looking for, well, there's raptors over there. There's a raptor swarm. One second. First of all, let's kill the raptor swarm, most likely, because I need experience. But first, look at it and think, wow. That's cool. There's a lot of them there. This could be a terrible idea. Ours is level 166, to be fair. No, it's 167 now, isn't it? Unless I leveled again, there's 160. Ah, there we are. That was easy. And now I devour my and now Bertha devours her brethren. Okay, so yeah, thank you so much for watching. If you have enjoyed the video, then of course, likes, favorite, shares, comments, all that good stuff helps out me, helps out the channel, and most importantly, shows that Ark Survival Evolved is a series you wish to see continued in the future on the channel. And with more content-filled episodes. Today was a kind of getting back into the swing of things episode, having a bit of a hunt and look around. So thank you, and goodbye.